Every once in a while, you come across a story of someone who faces trial after trial and still somehow manages to hold their head high, maintain a certain sense of positivity, and remain resolute in their belief that there is a purpose behind the many challenges they face. Danielle Spencer, the actress who played smart alecky Dee Thomas on the classic TV sitcom What's Happening, is one of those people. Now, before I start talking specifically about Danielle, let's spend just a couple of moments acknowledging the origins of the show that she co-starred in, What's Happening. Originally, ABC was trying to develop a television program based on the 1975 film Coolie High. However, the filmed pilot was so poorly received by test audiences that network head honcho Fred Silverman requested the project be started anew with a completely different cast of characters. So when What's Happening debuted as a summer replacement series in 1976, there really wasn't anything left from the movie. At best, you could say it was kinda inspired by the film, but you know what? Silverman was absolutely correct. He knew what he was doing because this new version was pure television gold. Now, I personally knew it was going to be a hit because the three main characters, Raj, Dwayne, and Rerun, were on the cover of Dynamite magazine. Back then, that's how I gauged a show or movie's popularity. Anyway, Rerun, played by the late, great Fred Barry, no relation to Ken, was of course a favorite of mine. That dude was really graceful for his size, and although he had said that What's Happening was one of his first gigs, you'd never know it. He came off as very polished and incredibly funny. And the same thing could be said for the young actress who played Raj's tattletale of a little sister, Danielle Spencer. Her delivery of her lines defied her years, and because of that, made the scenes that she was in some of the best and funniest on the show. No better example of that was the two-parter guest starring the Doobie Brothers. This thing is a classic, not only because the Doobies really seemed to be having a good time on the show, but also because the cast was really clicking in all cylinders. Yep, chemistry was everywhere. Plus, it didn't hurt that the producers allowed the band to play a ton of music in each episode. Seriously, folks, if you haven't seen these episodes, you really should. You are in for some wonderful tunes and a bunch of good laughs. Speaking of that episode, I can't help but share a recent tweet from none other than Miss Tootie herself, Kim Fields, where she points out that Danielle meeting the Doobie Brothers Michael McDonald was something that she's extremely envious of. Well, that and Danielle's awesome Barbie collection. But getting back to Danielle, like I said, this girl has definitely faced her share of trials over the years, the first coming while she was filming What's Happening. You see, she was in a very serious car accident with her stepfather, so serious in fact, that it took his life and put Danielle in a medically induced coma for weeks. When she awoke, she had no recollection of the experience. Her recovery was painfully slow. However, because this all happened between the filming of seasons, Danielle was able to return to work when What's Happening resumed production. Yep, TV viewers were none the wiser to the traumatic ordeal that Danielle had been through. What's Happening ran for 3 seasons before being canceled by ABC. After the show ended, Danielle traveled with her mother and more or less resumed a relatively normal life. She finished up high school and began navigating the choppy waters of college life. 6 years later, in 1985, the cast was reunited in What's Happening Now, which ran for another 3 seasons. While making recurring appearances on the new show, Danielle was still in high school, pursuing her dream of becoming a veterinarian. In 2001, during a segment on the Today Show which reunited the cast, Danielle talked about her career as a caregiver to animals. It was also very evident during that appearance just how close these 4 actors still were. Yep, even after years apart, they were all so comfortable with each other. Almost like family. Especially these 3. Although their entertainment careers had reached a logical conclusion, and they had all journeyed down unique paths, it was clear that these 3 were close and that they really cared about each other. In 2004, after experiencing balance and chronic pain issues, Danielle was diagnosed with spinal stenosis due to the injuries that she received in that horrible car accident of her youth. Despite some pretty major health issues that were really throwing her for a loop, Danielle made an appearance at the 2006 TV Land Awards, along with Allison Arngrim, yep, Nellie Olson from Little House on the Prairie. She accepted the award for the TV character most in need of a timeout. And while juggling her career as a vet, persistent health issues, along with occasional television appearances, now Dr. Danielle Spencer found time to write her memoirs, or better stated, a journal of what it was like to be a child star. Around the same time, Danielle told Ebony magazine, "I've made peace with the fact that surgeries, back pain, and walking with crutches will be part of my life forever. Some days are good, some days are difficult, yet despite the challenges, there are reasons to celebrate." Oh, holy cow, I've got to believe that at this time in her life, Danielle believed, or maybe better stated, hoped that the worst was behind her. Unfortunately, that was not the case. In 2014, Danielle was diagnosed with breast cancer and underwent a double mastectomy. Again, Danielle faced the ordeal with a tenacious spirit and a willingness to try and search for meaning behind the challenges that life was throwing her way. I've got to say, as always, this woman is deeply inspiring. And while I wish I could say that Danielle's triumphant battle with cancer was the end of this story, it is not. That darn car accident, yep, it reared its ugly head once again. In 2018, Danielle underwent emergency brain surgery. I'm not really sure what a bleeding hematoma is. That's what the doctors say they had to fix during her most recent surgery. Recovery, as you might expect, has been tough and slow. You would think that at some point along the way, the good doctor might start questioning why all of these challenges are being thrown her way. And yet we know that is not how Dr. Danielle Spencer thinks. During an interview on the Oprah Winfrey Network after her double mastectomy, Danielle said that these experiences, while difficult, have given her a strength that quite simply, she didn't know she had. Truthfully, this courageous woman is simply amazing. All right, one more picture. Let's do one with the whole gang together. It really was a tremendously fun show to watch. Anyway, please share your memories in the comments section. And while you're at it, I'd love a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and I would be honored if you would consider subscribing to my channel. I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.